A recent Halo Infinite toy leak seems to suggest that the Flood are returning in Halo Infinite. Is this leak accurate? We'll stay tuned throughout the whole video to understand all the details. One of the biggest issues going on with Halo Infinite and people speculating about this game and the campaign story is the Flood, right? There is a big emphasis on the return to the classic form when it comes to Halo Infinite. What's one of the enemy types that we haven't seen in a really long time that's key part to the original trilogy? The Flood. And these recent toy leaks seem to suggest that the Flood are in the game in some capacity. So if you guys like these news and informational videos, and if you want to stay up to date with everything going on with Halo as they ramp up to the release of Halo Infinite, make sure you tap subscribe. Let's get right into the content here. One of the biggest questions surrounding Halo Infinite as a whole is the Flood and if they are going to return. The last time we truly saw the Flood in a Halo game for the campaign side of things was Halo 3, which was back in 2007, which seems so surprisingly long ago when it was such a prominent force within the original trilogy that it seems like the Halo and the Flood have always been just like a major character within the franchise. But Reach didn't have the Flood, Halo 4 didn't have it, and also Halo 5 didn't have it as well, so it's been some time and people have really speculated if the Flood will return in Halo Infinite. And while these recent screenshots seem to suggest that that's probably going to happen, so a couple Mega Constructs toy reveals, which yes, we're going back to Mega Constructs leaks, but trust me, these are something that you really want to take a note of. So let's review these pictures and let's talk about them and whether or not they really suggest the Flood comeback, which a lot of people are speculating on. So let's move into this picture right here. So this first image I want to show you guys is an image of what looks to be just kind of like a regular Spartan toy helmet kind of thing. I think they're meant to kind of hold your minor little miniature toys. When you zoom in on the base of this, it looks like there's some kind of like plant-like tentacle flowery thing at the bottom of these bases, which is kind of interesting, which, and maybe if it looks a little blurry, I'm sorry, but that's because kind of the image in YouTube compression, but they kind of have like a tentacle-like aesthetic to them with a bit of a flowery kind of spore end to them, which looks very familiar to our familiar Flood forms that we had back in the original trilogy. As you can see, this Flood form right here, this is one of those minor like popcorn guys. Yeah, I'm sure you guys have shot it plenty of times. This looks very familiar to like their kind of tentacle out like reach with like a flowery end to them as well. Here's another in-game image from Halo 3. You can see the tentacle-like outreach with the flowery outreach right there. The kind of just really grasp onto your unfortunate souls, as we're kind of seeing right here with this Marine. Now that looks oddly familiar to these four like tentacle things that we're seeing right here. Now I tried searching online relatively briefly but thorough at the same time when it comes to trying to see if we can find some kind of Flood like plant objects within Halo's universe. We haven't seen that before, but this is a new Halo game with a lot of new things going along with it and maybe some new Flood forms going into this game as well, which, I mean, these look like tentacles from your original Flood forms right here on the ground for this Mega Construct setup right here. There's another image on the back of this box as well I want to showcase you guys. Here's the back of the box as well, which I think shows a much clearer image of these tentacle-like plant structures. So if we zoom in right here, obviously with these big red circles from a phone screenshots, but you can see that they have a very familiar profile and look to them, as you would think to have for like a Flood form of some sort. Again, we haven't really seen like a plant-like or a growth spore when it comes to the Flood. And it seems a little odd to have the Flood involved with this kind of setup that they have with, like, it seems like Spartan on Spartan, kind of trying to emulate the multiplayer kind of aspect in the way about in toys. But then you have the Flood growing right around them. Maybe this is kind of like setting up like a scene that we might have in a multiplayer map or something like that, where you have like Flood-like structures growing all around the world where you're trying to fight, you know, Spartan versus Spartan in this simulated war games that we currently have right now within the lore of Halo. Just saying, like, this little plant structure right here looks very, very, very familiar to these little outreachy spore guys that we've seen all throughout Halo's original trilogy. Now, why should we expect these to actually be the Flood in the first place? I mean, 343 have never actually implemented the Flood in a Halo game. And at this point, it seems like actually that the Flood have been out of Halo longer than in Halo. So why are many people online, and also including myself, kind of looking at these images, making it seem like this is the Flood returning in Halo Infinite? Well, a big thing is that Halo Infinite is setting itself up to be a good starting point for newcomers to come into the franchise. Halo Infinite is also drawing a lot of influence from the original trilogy when it comes to their gameplay mechanics, aesthetics, and just the general feel of what it means to play Halo. And what was the biggest threat to the original trilogy? It was the Flood. The Flood was the biggest enemy within the whole thing. They're the reason why you became friends with the, you know, the enemy you would fight along with in Halo CE with the Elites and the Covenant as a whole. And 343 has stated that they draw a strong influence from Combat Evolved for Halo Infinite. And they've said in the recent development updates for Halo Infinite, especially about the aesthetics and the environment, that they're drawing strong influence from Combat Evolved with the Pacific Northwest style of environments with a lot of tree, grass, and kind of mountainous terrain like we saw a lot in Combat Evolved in for Halo Infinite for Zeta Halo. But with all these different kind of factors taken into consideration, I think it all but confirms the Flood will be turning in Halo Infinite's campaign in some capacity. Plus, I think it would be just like an awesome reveal if you do the similar kind of thing that we had in Combat Evolved, but in Halo Infinite. Can you imagine all the Flood returning, you know, reaction videos being put up on the internet? I think every content creator who plays Halo is probably gonna post that on their YouTube channel, which I would absolutely love to have just a surprise return of the Flood come in Halo Infinite, which we do know that lore-wise with Zeta Halo, there was Flood experiments on ancient humans back in the day as well. And it seems that the Flood have been contained on Zeta Halo in some capacity. To the extent, we don't really know, as Zeta Halo is kind of known, but not really a whole lot of lore is written about this, but there is some really good lore that's been written involved with Zeta Halo before Halo Infinite's development. But with existing lore evidence, a strong emphasis on style gameplay and the reason to just jump back into the original trilogy and having it be a good starting point for new people for the franchise, Halo Infinite, I would be absolutely shocked if the vanilla campaign does not have the Flood in some capacity. I could see maybe later down the line if they want to do like a Flood infected version live event kind of thing for Zeta Halo for Halo Infinite, which would be really freaking awesome. But I do strongly believe that we will see the Flood in some capacity within Halo Infinite. I think all signs point to yes, but obviously we won't fully know until we actually get a chance to play this game. And I don't feel like we will know the Flood return in Halo Infinite until we actually get to play this game, most likely in November. Because can you imagine the Flood reveal in CE, and if you already knew that the Flood were going to be in the game, it would completely ruin the reveal and the return of that enemy type. So we're never going to get a true confirmation that the Flood are going to return in Halo Infinite. But I would be absolutely shocked from everything that we've seen, at least from these pictures and from previous images as well. And also just the general concept of Halo Infinite and what 343 has stated about their philosophies about this game. I would just be so shocked if we do not see the Flood return in this game. But until then, it's ultimately leaks and speculation. So until we got a firm confirmation about that, guys, I will let you guys know on this channel if we actually do. But I highly doubt that we ever will. So if you guys want to stay up to date with Halo, or if you missed any content from me recently, as we do upload daily on this channel, make sure you subscribe to the channel. Check out the videos on the screen right here if you missed any content from me recently. Thank you so much for watching. I greatly appreciate it. I'll catch you all in the next video. Peace out.